beer. It's been produced by mankind dating back to at least 3500 BC, and historians have argued that beer is responsible for building some of the world's first civilizations. Even icons of American history.
Beer.
Afternoon, everybody.
No, not these guys. Thomas Jefferson, Ben Franklin, Samuel Adams, and George Washington were all home brewers. Here at Northern Illinois University, a group of innovative engineering students created a nano home brewing system designed to automate the brewing cycle, increase process efficiency, and improve portability, all the while meeting regulated safety standards and, of course, making a great tasting cerveza.
Essentially, almost every single portion of this, we're able to apply the majority of classes that we actually took here. We touched on thermodynamics, heat transfer, electronic controls. We also went into fluid dynamics, static structures, and a lot of computer simulation. So we were able to tie all these elements together on top of some computer programming to actually make this process automated.
Basically, I started off as a home brewer about 3 years ago and just wanted to make the process easier. I mean, I went through it and it takes about 5 hours right now to actually make a full batch, and I want to get that time down. Okay, how this thing works is we start off with about 10 gallons of water in here that will heat up to about 155 degrees. We'll transfer over 8 gallons of that over into the second keg. That's where the grains and the barley are all located. So after an hour of mashing process with this whole thing, it'll like convert those starches from the grains into fermentable sugars that we can use later on. And then after the mashing is complete, we'll transfer over into this last keg right here, which will heat up to a boiling temperature. And then we add the hops to it. And then basically after it's all done with the hop additions, we'll crash cool this thing. We want to get it down to 70 degrees as fast as we can. This is just to prevent any kind of like bacterial growth or anything. Basically have a big vat of sugar water that's at 80 degrees. Bacteria is just gonna wanna grow in there. So we crash cool it, and then right here on this spout, obviously the hose won't be attached, but we'll have a bucket located underneath that where we'll drain out all the good fermentable wort, and then add the hops, and then it'll ferment for about 2 weeks.
This is a practical application of everything that we have learned in the mechanical engineering field. So we can take this, we can apply it, and then we can say, we designed this, we applied it, this is how I can apply this to your job.